Outer Spit Snow. I mean, also this morning we never had anything with United.
Yeah, it's probably also because of Mikey. But now it's Real Space hosting, so I don't know.
It's also a map I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know it either.
As if Mikey and Real Space are playing map routes that nobody else uses.
Hmm. Could be interesting. I wonder if this map has been played already. No.
I hope that there is more than one KO, but I assume it's just one.
Oh, you fly there. KO, how many people are we? 21.
It's always Meister who's KO'd first. Always. Imagine there comes a fun speed track and then he suddenly wins.
Again.
Ah, oh, this will take so long.
Hmm.
Oh, it should shine late. No.
was a little bit better than this morning.
I think this is a map that you would love to play against Ryulu in the final.
Maybe. Not sure.
Do you drift cancel in the last drift?
Yeah. Like in the middle of the turn already. I'm not even sure if it's much better. It's because of that I had to go wider. Why would you change the mood? It's not... Yeah. I don't know. There's only the thing, the part where you're underneath. Like
but
the tunnel.
I don't think that it is better in day.
Yeah, it's even worse in day.
Yeah. Hello, MGM. I'm not driving 24 hours on dirt, but I'm driving the competition 24 hours dirt. I'm driving, yeah, here and there an hour. I have the feeling he drives the exact same maps now.
Yeah, I just said that. Can you also say that in chat because I just said something else. Basically heavy space to shuffle. I finish. You should be able to. What is he doing?
I don't want to drive this to Derek Laguna again.
I don't want to drive the stadium one.
Oh. Jebate. Jebate.
Fuck, I crashed in the end. Over the curb there. The gap. Almost flipped over. It's so badly built. Why does he leave so much space where you can just hit the edge? Did you drift the like last turn complex after the freewheel?
No.
I wasn't sure about that drift.
Did you nose slide?
No, I drifted. It was pretty similar in speed. But like the rest of my run was good, so I don't know.
Yeah, the rest of my run was also good, but somehow I was 3 tenths behind after that one. And I think it was the nose slide line which was wrong. God, what is this?
Driving the start.
This track is questionable. Okay, the ending is so much different. It's a difference like day and night. Ledge move against the pillar. Oh,
I think I hit the palm. Yeah. Oh, Pietrini is saying minus minus, is he out? Why would he not drive? Even if he lost 20 seconds.
I thought I lost 20 seconds, but it's not that much actually. Surprised. Lagoon is not my friend today. Do we have multiple DNFs? That would be great.
Lounge just finished. He was waiting before the finish line.
Yeah, but Petrunio, Haxa? No, Petrunio finished. Okay. I just hate the fact that knockouts with 23 players take more time than knockouts with 27 players.
Or even with 50 players.
Always asking myself how to do that start. This is really badly built, the start.
Yeah.
The gears.
I got a lot of gear downstairs.
Yeah, exactly. The gears.
Get the turn.
Yeah, the gears is the one thing, and the other thing is that there are transitions that can make your auto slide. Here, MGM, United car. In team 2. If he's still here. Did you see the announcement regarding the RPG event tomorrow?
I just saw it a little bit. I didn't see a time yet though. I'm guessing it's 8 p.m.
Yes, it's 8 p.m.
Yeah, interesting. I guess we'll watch Formula 1 as a movie.
Oh, of course I fucked this up now. Let's see if I can come back a bit.
Yeah, it's just impossible. Oh no, oh wow, I have to do this one. Really so much there. I still don't understand why not more people are struggling with this. Okay, oh, still got a super good run, too, for me. Even though it had one crash. How are there not more people who have the same? I don't understand that. Like, how do so many people survive something like this? Like, hype only 4 seconds behind, how?
I'm actually not completely sure for tomorrow. So first of all, there is a track which is called The Great Escape on MX by Fish. And it is an RPG map. This is one thing that is weird to me.
The next map is The Great Escape, which will be played in rounds. That was already planned, and it's also in the feedback and stuff.
Ah yeah. So we will do a lot of things on this track.
Yeah. First that, then time attack, and then rounds.
Yeah, and I was thinking, is it maybe that map that I saw on MX? Because it's also RPG, it's super long. 19... what was it? 19 minutes? And yeah.
Yeah, I also thought I remember the map that was called the Great Escape. For that one.
But still, the annoying thing tomorrow is following. Like, you know, my struggles today, so many different cups to play. So, and tomorrow, there is like nothing. There is this 24-hour stirred ending. And I will not play that much though. And then there is the whole day nothing. Absolutely nothing. And then at 8 PM, are starting three things at the same time, like, ugh. First of all, this RPG thing, so. The second thing is, there is the match between TSM and Air, which is super interesting in United. I mean, I don't want to miss that, I actually want to watch this live, and not just later. And then there's also F1.
So much.
Oh, I expected a better local. Actually, this is not really much faster than what Pio Trunio had this morning.
He had a 0.9. I think I was like 2, 3, 10 faster or something. But yeah. Printed there.
Yeah, it wouldn't have been that easy to win the final if the opponent was Pio Trunio. And he getting this run.
Did you have a good one, though?
No, I didn't have any slowdowns. I think my the part before the grass was not too good, the castle. I was too early on descent, had to steer a bit, and I think I barely made the jump, and so on. Think they are lost there. But yeah, regarding the 24 hours race, I was asking myself if it is a 25 hours race. You know why.
Is the switch...
Okay. Yeah, we have this time switch and this torn corner.
I wouldn't know when the time switch is. Like, in which direction does it go? Like, it's the bad direction, right?
It's a good direction.
Good.
Winter is always the good direction.
Oh yeah, of course. I didn't even think about it. I just asked. I didn't even give one thought about it. No. But yeah, of course, makes sense.
So, yep, we are at 3 AM, we will go down to 2 AM, which means we have... If the competition would go from 3 PM to next day 3 PM, it would be a 25 hours competition.
Mm-hmm.
Now, in the Discord of the 24 hours race, I didn't see anywhere something written regarding when it ends. And then I watched into our team internal time shift table, and he actually put it there with 2 AM, so mm-hmm. 2 shifts starting at 2 AM.
I got slowed on the checkpoint. Could have been important. But yeah, how's that actually going? Started already, I guess.
Again, the question.
The 24 hour race, how is it actually going? I guess it started already?
Yeah, yeah. Well, our team is doing pretty good. Last information I had is that we were in second place. But that will change when I'm driving.
Is there a website for it, like with the other one?
I think so. I believe, yeah. And yeah, the thing is, I of course Firestorm was in the beginning playing a lot. He's of course doing very well, and Pinder of course as well. I saw Nixotica playing. He of course lost it a little bit, but he still did great times and consistency. As far as I saw, I was just shortly on the server when I made a break, and. And then cleared that thing with the CPs in sector times. I don't know if they are doing it the way I proposed it. But there were actually two things that were a bit annoying. The one thing that, well, they of course didn't make too many thoughts about where to switch. There is a part which is like, yeah, I think you saw it once or I told it once. There is a part with three CPs basically within 20 meters. So there is a long straight where you can rest a bit with your hands, and the straight ends with three CPs, tat tat tat. Two of them object CPs, so it's really quick. And now the people think, okay, this is the part here, we have to switch. But...
yeah, but you have the straight.
Yeah, this could have been the one thing. But the straight is actually not that long, or in regarding of times. The thing is that after this section come a lot of 4 second sectors, but the average is 5 seconds.
Mm-hmm.
So it is actually better to do it later. Yeah. And then right before the multi-lap there are 2-3 sectors with 6 seconds, and before then you have to do it. Yeah. Now I of course don't know if they changed it the way I said it to them. In that moment while I was just checking it, they of course made the player switch. That was a bit annoying to me. because they of course didn't use it while I was not ready. Of course they didn't understand how it should be important, but yeah, the other thing is that in the planning they are switching every single hour the player. So in the night, the plan by Snow is that always when there are just two people, that they are always switching every single hour. And I'm not sure if that's sensible, because the switches are costing time, obviously. And you don't want to do that too much, I think. Especially the sunset map version is of course only here for 2 hours. And when you have it just for 2 hours, why would you switch a player in between? Because when the map gets switched from day to sunset and from sunset to night, the map will be like skipped. So there you don't lose anything if you change the player. But within those 2 hours, it's not really needed, yeah.
Doesn't make any sense.
And
like, unless you drive so bad or so much worse in the second hour than the first hour, that you lose multiple seconds, then yeah, of course. But that shouldn't be the norm.
Let me ask Wildcat map? No, JR. Ah, this is not better.
I mean, Wildcat would at least have better scenery.
Map was more interesting with the old finish. I don't actually remember.
Me neither. I'm thinking of one thing, finish, but I think it's actually for a different map. Which is a little bit similar. This knockout is actually so boring.
Hmm.
It's top 12.
Oh, Petty played 3 hours in a row. Yeah. And I also would say that this makes more sense than changing after an hour. But I didn't really have enough time to think about that. The one guy in our team is doing all the organization and he's putting a lot of effort into that, which is really great to see. But little things like this, little details, yeah, I didn't really think too much about it when I saw it. I just think now about it when we want to play, that this is actually nonsense to switch it that often. It will just make us lose CPs for nothing. But I heard they also had server problems in the beginning, and but then they tried to continue like normally. I had a final on this map once, you know, against you.
Also?
No. Against Aibo.
Yeah, that's unfortunate. You had no chance.
Well, I was playing the Naito 2 all day.
Yeah, how did that go?
Well, the aim was to qualify for the playoffs in the championship, and I needed to be top 8, and I was on 8th. There were, I think, 2 people quite close with me in points, and then also some behind, good players, and yeah, it was super exciting actually. Long time I thought, okay, it's safe, because one guy where I knew he was close to me didn't attend, wasn't there. It was also not a good player, I should have beaten him, but he wasn't even there. And I thought, okay, then I'm probably safe, but actually there were 2 people behind that were super trained on these tracks, because they tried to, yeah, qualify over this last opportunity, get into the top 8. And yeah, it was no different, no? We all played on one single server together. And yeah, first round was perfect. I got first place. I got fourth place, but I got the same points than first place for the championship. And usually you had 4 different servers and you had 4 first places and they all had the same points for championship then. And now that everyone played together on one server, it meant that the first 4 places will get the same points, and I got 4th, that was good. In the second one I got 5th, that was of course a bit unlucky. So I got got points for 2nd place, you can say. And then, next up was semi-finals, and then you already saw exactly how, what the point system is doing. Like, in the rounds before, you had a full server with many people. That means if someone crashes, he loses a lot of points as well. And of course the point system itself was completely different. especially in the first round. In the second round already was the point system really annoying. There it was 50 points for first, 40 points for second, and then only 32 points and then just 2-point gaps. Like first place was so dominant. And also second. And I never had first or second, of course. Yeah. I had only third and fourth places, obviously. On this map I got eliminated once.
I remember.
And the
finish really fast, so.
I'm not sure actually, but I think yes. And at the semi-final, when we were only 6 players left, it all changed, of course, with the point system. Then it was just a 10-7-5-3-2-1. And still, it was quite obvious that the first or second place is making the difference, but fourth places, for example, are super bad. And yeah, I had all the unluck that you can imagine, basically, in the semi-final. And that put me into the situation that I had, that I was only on fourth, top three qualify for final, and the opponent in front of me had actually then a finalist round alone, and then it changed to his best map and to my worst map, and I actually managed to beat him then twice. When we were 1v1 and qualified for the final. But then he also qualified for the final because one player didn't attend, and that was super important. I thought, okay, I got maximum points in the first round, then second place in the second round, and I was not sure, maybe even some players didn't attend, and then I qualified for the final. I was like, yo, this should be good enough, I will definitely be safe in the top 8. And then I see the announcement for the grand final, and then they write, Marius is safe in the playoffs if he gets not last. But if he gets last, and Bensworth wins, then Bensworth would actually qualify and Marius would be out. And if Maimo Jr. wins and Marius doesn't attend in the grand final, then Maimo Jr. has still the chance to win.
Well,
so
yeah.
I was
attending.
So that means that Bensworth and Maimo Jr. were two players that were actually behind, and they both qualified for the grand final. And the guys that, for example, the guy that I have beaten, that was usually would have been out now, he was. Still in the championship in front of me, together with 3 other guys. They were like 5 points in front of me, or 4 points, after a year of championship. And the thing is, in the final we have 6 players, and first place gets 8 points, and then 5-4-3-2-1 for the championship. So last place gets 1 point, but if you want to get 4 points and catch up to those, well, then you need to be a third already in the final. You need to have a really good, really good position there. So it was not logically and easy to reach that, to get that aim. And yeah, the thing is, I wasn't really sure if I am safe not last in that final. And then the question is, will Bensworth win? But Aurel was there, and he was pretty dominant all the time before, but you never know, it's finalist mode and so on. And yeah, then I was a bit shaky about that, and yeah, I was correctly shaking, because I got last in the final. There was just no chance with that point system to do anything, was also a bit unlucky, but the good thing is, that right before the grand final, something unexpected happened for Bensworth, and he couldn't attend, so he didn't come. And he got replaced by the guy that I have beaten in the semi-finals. And yeah, then it was safe for me. I attended, so Maimo Jr. also didn't have any chance, and Ben Swerd wasn't there to win. But if he was there, he would have had a chance, maybe. Because Aurel was not dominating it. It was Snow dominating, and Snow didn't finish off in the finalist status for like 6 or 7 rounds. And then it was close between many people. But yeah, point system 10-7-5, 3-1, which means 4th place of 6 players in a round only wins 2 points and someone who completely crashes, but alone 1 position ahead, 3rd place, is already 2 points better than you. And first map, I got 3 times 4th of 3 rounds. When we went through the whole map rotation and came back to that map, I got again 2 times 4th. And in general, I had so many 4th places, you can't count. And of course I never won. And they came to the cut map, of course, yeah. And they all did know the cut in the end. They all learned it. Saw it, found it, and
which cut? Well, that's what I was asking myself.
Yeah, your cut, the fastest one.
Okay.
And
you get it most of the time?
Yeah. Yeah. In the first round, Snow drove it and he got 3 times a 48 seconds time. 3 times. He did a faster way in the start. He didn't go back to the water. Instead, he was just going onto the green from the starting block to get grip and accelerate. It is actually the usual thing to do. I was also just thinking the water would in that case be better because you have the better correct... you stand in the correct direction then.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking.
And it's not that... not super trivial and easy to be faster with this strategy. Because you really have to touch the green from the start and get around somehow then. But yeah, still it's quite obvious that it was faster. But yeah, he got consistent 48s in the first round with it.
But I learned it like in the rounds before from you. Like in the water semi and stuff.
I'm not sure. It might be that they that some of them already knew it beforehand. Might be. Might be that there were also others not showing it.
I was asking myself in this round how many we are actually, because I kind of felt not that safe with that one.
Hello Dervik. Thanks to Iconi for the gift. Ah yeah, he was here yesterday. It was not... I think who got picked was in the end random. He gifted like 5 subs or something like that. Oh, you got 3 gifted subs on different channels in 1 hour. Wow. That's actually interesting. I'm not sure if it was enough to unlock new emotes, I have to check. I mean, it might be not enough.
What would be the next emote? Marius 5 Dab?
Nah, sing then. The microphone, which was actually planned all the time. I was singing today, actually.
Oh. Worked?
Not sure how many people heard it here in my barrack. Barrack. Barrack Obama. I still don't know what is that surface in the tunnel.
I think it's sand.
Yeah, sand but flat.
Yeah.
Because how it's would you know how sand is driving when it's flat?
Oh my god. I got an insane oversteer and just... I was first in the checkpoint, but I needed to respawn directly in this far sector. Right before this long straight on sand, where you don't really accelerate that much. I got the last turn good though. I was by far like three last. Was needed. Okay, no, it wasn't. I was close to the roof there at the end, like really close.
Yeah.
Although I don't think you can get the last turn much better than I just got it.
Ah, and Derwig is saying Marius disconnect. Marius 5 disconnect is next emote. But how would it look like?
Like a red Viking arrow, like how you draw an arrow when it's like from a lightning strike, you know? Like that, what do you call it? I don't know what how I would call it, I wouldn't even know how I would describe it in German. Then it gets serious, finally. And then directly comes the United Car Map and I'm instantly out. It's 2.6 seconds and I'm saving so much. Wait, didn't I have a good time on here? I saved.
Not sure how often we played it.
I remembered I had good fights with Voyager on this track. When my last turn was really good, I held the drift the whole way and didn't really compromise myself.
But if that run was saved, well...
It was clean. at least. Didn't risk anything.
Yes, I watched F1 quali.
Did you actually watch the Twitch stream a little bit?
No.
Oh, not at all.
No, I didn't.
I only had it on in case my stream dies. Because I like, even though, yeah, okay, it's German, but I don't like it. I don't even want it to be German. I like it more in English. Even if it was like the best German cast you could think of, I would probably still not like it. Oh, that checkpoint. Well, this actually is an important map now. I don't know it. Never played it before.
I spectated the final here once. And Voyager was in it.
I'm definitely doing the start one, but how would I do it now?
Yeah, this is ripped for me. Because I'm happy with my start, but Maxi is far ahead.
I was happy with my start and I was 7/10 behind. And I didn't remember anything from the track now.
Now we are much closer.
Crashed. Complete oversteer there. And it's gone. There's nothing I can do. What is this shit map? I knew it was so clear with such a boring KO that there's gonna come a bullshit track in the actually important round. And I'm directly out. And like, literally, I have no chance. What am I supposed to do after I touch a little bit? It's literally impossible.
Yeah, I don't like such maps as well. Especially here, there is not a single corner. This is just a magnet and then it's over. If you have more speed after the magnet, then you have a big advantage already. Amateur caster super cringy on Twitch. We know what happened this morning on this track here. It again comes after you are out.
Yeah. And I really like this map. Really good one for me.
It's, you know, that's always the thing. Someone goes out, his best environment or map or something afterwards. For my taste, it is much, way too much canyon now.
What are you doing? Like Maxi, everyone.
I was happy with my run.
Look very un like it turns look very under Stevie.
Yeah. Posadas is still one of my Kenyan favorites. Oh, thanks. My favorite Envy mix. Oh god. Whew. Rally on Coast. Oh no, not the lag again, Lagoon. Why do I have
At
Lagoon?
Least this is an actual Lagoon map.
Yeah, this is bad for me now.
Yeah.
Especially the fact that it's a Lagoon map that I don't know that well. It's not a track that we played multiple times already. What I want to say is that this is a track that I have to learn in the warm-up. It's not like I go to this track and I already know everything. I think this is pro Voyager, this map. Yeah, as I said, like I can't do much better than that.
Yeah, your speed was bad out of the second wood part, or the last wood part, was important. Like you were still very close there and then you just had no speed afterwards.
Oh, wait, you mean the second one with a booster?
Yeah.
I thought I got that decent. But I was jumping so far in that magna, but I think that's something you have to do. Who's gonna start in the dirt race? Well, my team is with Firestorm, Pinda, Pixel, Nixotica and Snow. Oh, I got some spins. And we have a schedule, yes. And yeah, it started already at 3 p.m. Let's say I'm training in 1.5 hours. I told them it's not good if I start at midnight, because then we will just lose a lot of checkpoints if I go there with less train. also I need my disconnect to happen before we go live. That's also important. I mean, in the schedule, I'm driving the shift from midnight to 1 o'clock, then someone else from 1 o'clock to 2 o'clock, then from 2 o'clock to 3, from 2 to 3 myself, then the other 2 to 3, again the other guy. I don't think it makes that much sense to switch every single hour. But yeah, we will see. I told him he shall start.
Oh, don't see you.
Oh, Danik, nice. I just lost my knockout final. But was to be expected. I'm happy with my performance. I'm just unhappy that this didn't play any role. You directly see who voted for Lagoon. Now you see it even better.
Yeah, I'm definitely not playing that. I'm so annoyed by Lagoon.
Yeah, I'm also not playing it because I have to drive RPG. That's then more important.
Yeah, me too. Not sure about the time attack. 20 to 40 now. Many people are we? 14.
How went RPG? Everyone found the cut. Lars is only 9th. I played it for 10 minutes before the knockout and got a run through 15th local. But I have to train it still.
So if we survive it, the upper till the end. We would have 50 minutes on the
RPG. Is this a knockout track?
Yeah.
Oh no. The start? I thought it's an Adio track. In Turbo you have some track like this, right? Or is or was it no, the Team 2 campaign?
It's in the Team 2 campaign.
Ah, okay.
But yeah, this looping. What the fuck? Like, I think the start is fine and all, but this looping, what the fuck? How can this be accepted?
Yeah, probably Wildcat accepted it or something. He says, looping, oh my god! Looping? This is perfect! What a great track! What a nice time to be alive! Oh, I tried something.
Like, I'm about to leave when I see this shit. Like, why am I even bothering? Basically, because it's time attack, it can be bad.
This is so stupid. Like, every noob can beat me, in theory, on such a track. Speaking about
like, you can also never get a run in on this kind of map. Because you're always gonna fly out somewhere. I got only one single run where I survived. I didn't fly out. This is fucking stupid, what the fuck? Imagine this comes up in the final. Like, seriously.
Oh, Well, that's my PB in dirt. 27, I think.
Actually, no DNF on the last map, so actually everyone managed to get a run, and I'm kind of surprised.
Well, played, was not AFK.
Yeah, of course, but then it would say DNF.
Imagine you come into a final against like Aibo, think okay it's all easy or fine, and then comes this map and he beats you.
Yeah, you have no chance, it's complete luck.
Oh, how is this not a new world record on this new map version? I got exactly what I wanted, I got the snap. This is why I'm leading by far probably. Got against something. Yes.
Oh. This is also kind of a map which can just also get deleted.
Yeah, but also think like that. Even it's though I like
just
to have a trick.
Jump onto the dirt, it's nothing else.
This was almost perfect. Holy shit.
I just improved by 1000. Like the rest of the track, there's nothing. Literally nothing. It's just.
Yeah, the gap is so... Well, Hugs! The gap is so incredibly huge.
Wait, friend... Hugs?
Yeah.
Yeah, this is what I mean.
The gap is so incredibly huge to when you don't get the snap. You have basically no chance to drive under... to beat Hugs, basically. It's almost not possible.
But you can beat Hugs. My one wasn't perfect, but... Below 0.9 is difficult. Probably possible, I could see an 85 maybe, but 74? No.
Yeah, and what did I have on the old version of the map? Maybe even 0.6?
Yeah, I think so. I never got that snap. I never went for it.
Basically, I just went for it, and I got it 3 times. And the last one I was then to inside, but that would have been the best one. If that was... not too early in the corner, that would have been the best one.
This is also something. Which is like, why even, does this even exist? And you're of course too fast for that downhill.
Mm-hmm.
It's so bad. How the fuck does Voyager drive in 0.18? Like... Yeah, how? What are you doing there? Do you do it full speed?
No, but it wasn't perfect. I could have gone 0.0.
Hey?
Yeah, I could have. Like, I got a little oversteered at it.
I went like so close to the wall and was so on the edge everywhere. Yes. I would think maybe 1 or 2 hundredths at most.
I was already ahead a bit in the start, like every time. You might have seen it in the checkpoints. My first run, which was long time PB, was having a good start, and I exactly equaled it on the 1000.
I never checked that.
But yeah, releasing in the street corner, keeping grip, and then full speed through the dirt. And I got a little oversteer.
What was the strategy for this one again?
Oh fuck, I wanted to just test it. Yeah, I kept on the banked part.
Like on the top part constantly?
I stayed on the banked. But now I'm trying the other thing, which my opponent in the one final did. He had low speed afterwards, but I wanted to check.
I bugged 3 times now, where I lost like half a second. Yeah.
Don't know, this map is so weird.
You had like no proper map yet. But this doesn't look like something that I would like, but it looks at least like as if there's effort in the track.
So old map.
Also much more complex than the other ones.
Oops.
It has 2 turns instead of 1.
How is this not a PB? I mean a new personal local. Okay.
Yeah. But also that 49 there was my first try in this session and I couldn't beat it. I didn't feel that good. I guess was.
But then you hit the inside finish in your first try.
Oh.
My first try, I didn't see that there is a jump before the last one. This is actually the same as many other tracks. You, every noob can beat you here. Like, also can beat me. This third turn feels so wrong, so weird. Or let's put it that way. I once did the upper corner full speed and got world record with it. But it is absolutely not consistent. And I have no idea why it worked in that one run.
Yeah, I have no idea how to approach. Like, it's only the exit. Like, you can do everything fine up until the exit. Then you slide. No, I'm still in the end for some reason. I'm a second behind.
Yeah, these times. I was so happy about my run.
I'm really happy with that one.
So I think, yeah, exactly. My PB, you will see it now. A 0.89, lol. In that PB, I actually crashed. I actually touched a wall at the exit of the dirt uphill corner, but I didn't lose a lot of speed with that. And it was much better than any other try where I released a bit to not hit the wall. And even now I couldn't beat it. Like, I'm really clueless on that track.
Yeah, it's really stupid. The track also seems very simple. Is this completely full speed? The only thing.
Oh no, you have to avoid the obstacles in the ending.
The obstacles?
It's a well, boat.
Okay. Then now I actually went with Cap 7 because you see these, like the item car and stuff. I thought maybe you were, there would be some traffic or something.
Did you bait?
Do you drift that turn?
Slightly, yeah.
Ah, yeah, no, I think I got it. So weird to drive. Nothing.
Wow, the last sector, the last CP is so far away. I drove so long to just see in the finish if it was faster or not. Sinas uphill! Thanks a lot. I didn't hear a sound. That was weird. I didn't hear any sound about that raid. It's so weird. Sometimes I hear sound and nothing happens. There's just some auto host. Oh lol. Sometimes I hear nothing, but I see it at least. But yeah, thanks a lot for the raid and hello everyone, hello Hunter.
He put more effort into that outro than in the whole map.
Yeah. Oh my god, Patty is actually, yeah, out on stadium. What the fuck? Did you actually see in Paddy Productions the A and O? Probably he's also an overachiever.
I guess rather Achiever over.
Yeah.
Jetzt auf die Bahn. Auf der Paddy.
Ja, ja. Well, at least it's not Stadium after this out.
I never get that final turn. Always way too wide. But I don't get the turn out
user
of the,
joined your channel.
Hello.
Oh, hi.
I'm gonna drive the RPG now.
Nice. Yeah. We join
we will
in,
join in
7 minutes.
6 knockouts. Or 5.
Okay, it's a bit more than 7 minutes.
About 10 minutes. And yeah, it seems like Wingo Bear found the same thing and he basically showed everyone.
Yeah.
Not sure if he somehow found it by someone else or if he found it out by someone who saw my stream, but he never really showed it in the stream.
Yeah.
Well.
Just as it's out. Yes.
Some training for 24 hours still to this man.
Why can't you take your first shift, Marius?
It would be better if, I mean, I will play RPG until exactly midnight. It would be better if I can learn the track a bit before playing.